morning. God is good.
Amen. All the time.
And if you weren't in Sunday school, you missed out. This morning I'm going to be reading out of Romans 8, starting in verse 25. That's Romans 8, starting in verse 25. Let me name when we get there.
Amen. everybody. Take your seats.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm so glad that everyone's here this morning. Some faces we haven't seen. God bless you, brother. Praise the Lord. Brothers over here, thank you, Jesus. You know, God is so good. We stop and we think, how many times has God answered our prayers when we least expect it? Well, I heard a comment this morning that God never forgets our prayers. It's in due time when He answers them. And we say, Lord, now. Well, God knows His timing. And so by that I mean, if you've been praying, you've been asking God for something in your life, like I've been asking God, who knows that God's timing is today. Amen. Call out to Him. Any questions you have, I guarantee you by the end of the service, the Holy Spirit will minister to you. Amen. So my prayer is that you be blessed today. Those of you that hear through social media and those of you here today, the Lord bless you. And thank you so much for visiting with us today. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord. We have a wonderful service ready. I'm expecting a wonderful message from the Lord this morning, right? And today we're just so blessed to have Bishop David Salazar and his lovely wife. God is good. It's so good to see all of y'all. So good to have you join us this morning to bless the Lord and just to worship Him. And so thank the Lord. We just give Him glory and honor. We also want to thank the Lord because Pastor is here with us. So.
Amen.
Lord, we've been great mighty things for the Lord, from the Lord. And so we're praying for miracles.
Yes.
We believe in a miracle-making God.
Okay? Yes.
So I always say, what is it that you need? That is what He is. ¿Qué es lo que necesitamos? Eso es lo que Dios es, ¿verdad? He's our Jehovah Jireh, nuestro Jehová Jireh. He's our Jehovah Rofeca, ¿verdad? Nuestro Jehová Rofeca. ¿Verdad? Lo que necesitamos es lo que es Dios para con nosotros. All we have to do is have faith.
Amen.
Tenemos que tener es tener fe, ¿verdad? Porque Dios no ha cambiado. My God has not changed.
Amen.
So let's bless the Lord. Let's just continue to praise the Lord. And continue to believe that God is still the same. The Word of God says that He is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
Jesucristo es el mismo ayer y hoy por todos los siglos, ¿verdad? Así es que le alabamos al Señor en esta mañana. Let's go ahead and stand and just prepare to pick up our tithes and our offerings. We have, like I said, we have a wonderful message planned for us, and we're also going to take communion. So please prepare your hearts. Prepare your hearts and your minds, first of all, to give unto the Lord what belongs to the Lord, and then prepare our hearts and our minds to receive from the Lord as we partake of communion this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. Thank you, my Jesus. Brother Collins, would you lead us in prayer, please?
Father, in the name of Jesus, I do pray to you, thank you for this day, Lord Jesus. Thank you for this chance just to give back unto you, Lord Jesus, for the needs of the church. I ask that you bless those people that give today, Lord Jesus. Open the windows of heaven and pour out blessings upon them, Lord Jesus. Let them see that you are faithful and loving God, Lord, and that you have our needs in mind, Lord. And I ask that you bless those who can't give as well, Lord Jesus, and just be with us in the service today. We give you praise and thanks in your mighty name. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Thank you.
Dios, aleluya.
Glory to God, aleluya.
¿Quién vive?
Jesús.
A su nombre.
Gloria.
Porque venimos a adorar a un Dios vivo. Y a eso nos venimos esta mañana. Hemos venido a darle gracias a Dios. ¿Cuántos están contentos esta mañana? ¿Cuántos están felices esta mañana? ¿Sabe por qué, hermano? Porque Cristo está en su corazón. Triste aquellos hermanos que no tienen a Cristo. Y no tienen la paz en su corazón. Pero nosotros somos bendecidos con la presencia del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. El título de éxito en Cristo Jesús.
Our title for this morning is Success on Jesus Christ.
Amen. Y vamos a abrir la palabra de Dios en Juan 21:5.
We're going to open our Bibles to John 21:5.
Tenga, puede decir un amén.
You can say amen when you found it.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
1:21:5.
John 21:5. Lord.
Amen.
Praise
you. Hallelujah. Hermano, we have that too. We were here. Hold my mic. PowerPoint. Dice así en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Y les dijo: hijitos, ¿tenéis algo de comer? Le respondieron: no. Él les dijo: echad la red a la derecha de la barca y hallaréis entonces. Y la echaron y ya no podían sacar por la gran cantidad de peces.
John 21:5-6 says: Then Jesus said unto them, children, have you any fish? They answered him, no. And he said unto them, cast the net on the right side of the ship, and you shall find. They cast therefore, and now they were not able to drive for the multitude of fish.
Amén. Padre eterno, en esta mañana.
Padre,
estamos delante de tu presencia. Y pedimos tu guianza. Pedimos tu dirección. Pedimos tu Espíritu Santo, Señor, toque nuestra mente y corazón. Para poder compartir esta palabra.
So we can share the word of God.
Con amor.
With love.
Para cada uno de mis hermanos.
To each of our brothers.
Padre, toca cada corazón de ellos también.
Father, touch each heart.
Tú conoces la necesidad.
You know the need.
Tú conoces, Señor, el corazón.
You know the heart.
Señor, y tú vienes a bendecirnos a cada uno de nosotros.
Por eso
te lo pedimos en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Amén. Pueden sentarse.
Amen.
La palabra del Señor,
the word of God,
nos va a hablar esta mañana.
Is going to talk to us.
Pero doy gracias a Dios.
And I give thanks to the Lord.
Nuestro pastor Jaime Castellano.
For Pastor Jaime Castellano.
Por la oportunidad de compartir la palabra de Dios esta mañana.
For the opportunity that he gave us to share the word of God this morning.
Y ahora tengo un challenge.
Y en today I have a reto.
Tengo un challenge ahora.
Un reto today.
Porque tenemos a David Salazar, el bishop.
Amen. We have Bishop David Salazar present.
Y a nuestro pastor aquí.
And his wife and his daughter.
Así que me siento como que estoy pasando un examen de la escuela.
So I feel like I'm passing a test from school.
En esta misma condición, hermano.
In this same condition, brother.
Se encontraba Pedro.
Peter found himself.
Pedro estaba en la barca, ¿no? ¿Qué estaba haciendo Pedro en la barca? Estaba pescando.
Peter was in his boat and he was fishing.
Él tenía, hermanos, un trabajo que hacer, Pedro.
He had a job to do.
Pero no sabía que se iba a encontrar, hermano, con un reto.
But he didn't know he was going to find a challenge.
Cuando él estaba buscando, hermano, algo en la vida.
When he was trying to look for something in life.
Para poder vivir.
To be able to live.
encontró que se encontraba en un test.
He found himself in a test.
Quizá, hermano, cuando nosotros vamos a trabajar,
maybe when we go to work,
estamos cansados.
We're tired.
Porque hemos trabajado bastante.
Because we have worked a lot.
Y Pedro había trabajado todo el día.
And Peter had worked all day.
Y toda la noche.
And all night.
Y no nomás era él solo.
And it wasn't only him.
Tenía todos sus ayudantes que estaban con él.
But he had all his helpers with him.
Y todos estaban cansados.
And they were all tired.
Con hambre.
Hungry.
Cuando llega Jesús.
When Jesus arrived.
Y les pregunta lo que no tenían.
And he asked them for what they didn't have.
Y les pregunta, ¿tienen algo de comer?
And he asked them, do you have something to dine?
Hermano, yo puedo ver algo importante aquí.
Brother, I can see something important here.
Que Pedro fue sincero.
That Peter was truly.
Muchas veces nosotros no queremos decir, hermano, la verdad de nosotros mismos.
Many times we want to say our own truth.
Porque no nos conviene.
Because it's not convenient for us.
Porque yo digo siempre, me ha pasado a mí, hermano.
Because it has happened to me, brother.
Digo, si digo esto, a lo mejor me puede ir mal.
If I say this, maybe it's going to be bad for me.
Pero Pedro fue bien honesto, hermano.
But Peter was honest.
Jesús le preguntó, ¿tienes algo de comer?
Jesus asked him, do you have something to eat?
Y él dijo, no.
And he answered, no.
¿Por qué?
Why, brothers?
Muchas veces nos preguntan, hermano, ¿está bendecido?
Many times you say, brother, are you blessed?
Y usted está cargado de problemas, hermano, de tantas cosas de la vida.
And you have so many problems in life.
Y usted dice, sí.
And you say, yes.
Pedro no podía decir, sí, estoy bendecido.
Peter couldn't say, yes, I'm blessed.
Porque su barca estaba vacía.
Because his boat was empty.
Y los que estaban con él estaban con hambre.
And the ones with him were hungry.
Y estaban todos remojados de la misma agua del mar.
They were probably wet from the water from the sea.
¿Quién contestó la verdad? No.
And he answered the truth. No.
Entonces Dios dio una nueva orden. Jesús dio una nueva orden.
Then Jesus gave a new order.
Quizás el resultado de nuestro trabajo que nosotros podemos hacer.
Maybe the result of the job that we can do.
Muchas veces no es el que buscamos.
Many times it's not the one that we're looking
for. No es el que obtenemos.
It's not the one that we obtain.
Pero a pesar de todo lo que nosotros podemos pasar,
but even though what we can go through,
tenemos que creer,
we have to believe,
que Jesús puede cambiar todo.
That Jesus can change everything.
Y ellos estaban asombrados.
And they were amazed.
Porque el que les hablaba,
because the one that he was speaking to them,
ellos podían reconocer su voz.
They could recognize his voice.
Porque nunca dijo Jesús, yo soy Jesús. El que andaba con ustedes allá por Jerusalén, predicando el evangelio.
Because Jesus never said, I am Jesus, the one that was walking with you in Jerusalem preaching the gospel.
Soy el hijo del carpintero, José.
I am the son of the carpenter, Joseph.
Él solamente habló.
He just spoke.
Y cuando él habló,
and when he spoke,
los discípulos reconocieron esa voz.
The disciples recognized his voice.
Qué tremendo eso, hermano.
It's wonderful, brothers.
Por eso, hermano, sabía Pedro que no podía mentir.
That's why Peter knew he couldn't lie.
Porque conocía esa voz que le estaba hablando.
Because he recognized the voice that was talking to him.
Y tenemos que creer que Jesús todo lo puede.
And we believe that Jesus knows everything. He can do everything.
Muchas veces queremos, hermano, bendiciones y bendiciones y bendiciones.
Many, many times we want blessings and blessings for our life. Yeah.
Los discípulos sabían que Jesús podía multiplicar los peces.
The disciples knew that Jesus was able to multiply the fish.
Porque ellos habían multiplicado ya una vez con ellos.
Because he had already multiplied those fishes before.
Ellos vieron a aquel niño que traía aquellos peces y aquellos panes.
Yeah. They saw the boy that had the fishes and the bread.
Y lo multiplicó a Jesús. Yeah.
And Jesus multiplied them.
Ahora, Pedro quería multiplicar los de él.
Now, Peter wanted to multiply his.
Pero estaba vacía.
But the boat was empty.
No los pudo multiplicar.
He couldn't multiply them.
Todos queremos bendición.
We all want blessings, brothers.
Un ejemplo.
An example.
Este hombre quería, hermano, ser bendecido.
This man wanted to be blessed.
Y le pidió a Dios algo.
And he asked God for something.
Le dijo, todo lo que toque se convierta en gold.
I want everything that I touch to be converted in gold.
Hermano, llegó a su casa.
He went to his house.
Tocó la puerta.
He knocked the door.
¿Qué pasó?
What happened?
Se convirtió en gold.
It became bold.
Wow. Hermano, se sentó en la silla de la sala.
He sat in the chair on the living room.
La que siempre se sienta el papá cuando llega del
trabajo. The one that the father always used when he arrived from work.
Bien cansado de trabajar y se sienta.
When he's tired from work, he sits down in the chair.
Cuando se sentó.
When he sat down.
Puso su mano en los
handles. He put his hands in the handles.
Y se comenzó a mover.
And he came to bow.
Y la esposa, wow!
And the wife was amazed.
La esposa estaba feliz, hermano.
His wife was happy.
Porque ahora había oro por todos lados en su casa.
Because now she had a lot of gold all over her house.
Cuando hay necesidad en nuestro hogar, hermano.
When there's need in our home.
Y cuando llega la bendición, hermano, la cara nos cambia.
And the blessings arrive or they change.
Porque ahora vemos la bendición de Dios en el hogar.
Now we see God's blessing in the house.
Y la esposa estaba tan feliz que dijo, Jali, vente a la mesa a comer una rica comida.
And the wife was so happy that she said, honey, come to the table and eat a really good food.
Voy a sacar la mejor comida.
I'm gonna cook the best food.
De mariscos, carne,
seafood, fish.
De todo, una barbecue de lo mejor.
Everything, the best of the best.
Y cuando se sentó en la mesa.
And when he sat down on the table.
Tocó la mesa.
He touched the table.
Se convirtió en oro.
And he became gold.
Wow, la esposa estaba más feliz. Ya me casé, pastor.
The wife was amazed. She didn't know what to do with so much gold.
Entonces agarró el plato de comida.
Then he got a plate of food.
¿Y qué tiene que pasar?
And guess what happened?
Se convirtió en oro.
It became to gold.
Y ya no se pudo comer.
And he couldn't eat it.
Entonces le dijo a la esposa.
Then he told the woman, oh,
¿qué pasó?
What happened?
Dijo, pues, es que yo oré.
It's because I prayed.
Y le pedí a Dios que todo lo que tocara se convirtiera en oro.
And I asked God that everything that I touch become gold.
Y ahora tengo hambre.
Now I'm hungry.
Pero no me puedo comer la comida.
But I cannot eat my food.
¿Qué tengo que hacer?
What do I have to do?
Tengo bastante hambre.
I'm really hungry.
Luego la esposa, pues vamos a orar.
And the wife said, let's pray.
Vamos a orar.
Let's pray.
Y empezaron a orar.
And they started to pray.
¿Cuál creen que la oración hicieron?
And what prayer do you think they did?
Esto me pedí, Señor.
This man said, Lord.
Yo te pedí que todo lo que tocara se convirtiera en oro.
I asked you that everything I touched became gold.
Pero ahora yo te pido.
But now I ask you.
Que todo lo que te pedí se vuelva normal.
That everything that I asked you before go back to normal.
No terminaron de orar.
But they finished praying.
Ya la comida se había hecho comida.
Now the food was in the table.
Hermano, muchas veces buscamos el éxito.
Many times we look for success.
Pero el éxito que obtenemos muchas veces no es el que nos va a saciar nuestra vida.
But many times the success that we are looking for is not the one that is going to please our life.
Pero andamos buscando lo mejor para él y su familia, y sus amigos, los discípulos que estaban con él.
Peter was looking for the best for him, his friends, his family.
Pero no sucedió de la manera que lo quería.
But it didn't happen the way he wanted.
Muchas veces nosotros llevamos, hermanos, la vida como Pedro.
Many times we are ahead our life just like Peter did.
Me ha pasado a mí.
It has happened to me, brother.
La vida cristiana es un aprendizaje diario.
A Christian life is a learning.
Si yo digo que todo lo sé, hermano, desde que nací.
And if I tell you that I know everything since I was born,
le voy a echar una mentira.
I would be lying to you.
Tengo que decir como Pedro, no.
I have to say just like Peter.
Todo lo he aprendido día tras día.
I have learned everything day by day.
Aunque Pedro había estado con Jesús, hermano.
Even though Peter was with Jesus.
Aún le tocaba a él, hermano, aprender algo más.
Now it was his turn to learn something else.
Hermano, que llevaba su barca vacía.
His boat was empty.
Y lo más tremendo de todo esto, hermano, no era el problema que la barca estaba vacía.
And the problem was not that the boat was empty.
Que el hombre de Dios estaba allí.
Is that the man of God was right there.
Y no tenía nada que ofrecer.
And he didn't have nothing to offer him.
Muchas veces nosotros venimos a Dios, hermano.
Many times we come to God, brothers.
Y decimos, yo no tengo nada que ofrecerte.
And we say, I don't have anything to offer you.
Yo no soy nada, Dios mío.
I'm nobody, Lord.
Hoy en la escuela dominical yo lo decía.
Today in Sunday school I mentioned that.
Yo salí de un pueblo muy pequeño.
I got up from a really small town.
Y yo pensé, no voy a cruzar mis cinco cuadras cuando ya voy a tener que estar de regreso a mi mi casa.
And I thought, I'm not going to be able to cross 5 blocks and I'll be back home.
Porque sentía mi barca vacía.
Because I felt that my boat was empty.
No había la solución que yo quería para mi vida.
The solution for my life was not there.
Y ahí estaba el que le pedía algo a Pedro y no lo tenía para el Señor.
And there was the one that Peter was asking for, and he didn't have it.
¿Qué es verdaderamente el vacío de tu corazón?
What is the void from your heart?
¿Cuál es el verdadero vacío de nuestra vida?
What is the true emptiness of your life?
Y caminando en la vida cristiana, hermano.
And walking in Christian life, brothers.
Hay muchos cristianos vacíos de amor.
There's many Christians that are empty of love.
Pedro no tenía pescados en el barco.
Peter didn't have fish in his boat.
Pero hoy en día, hermano, podemos comparar.
But nowadays we can compare.
Cristianos, hermano, que están vacíos de amor.
Christians that are empty from love.
Yo creo que aquí no hay uno de eso, ¿verdad?
But we don't have none but right here.
Y
right?
No vamos a mentir.
We're not
Pedro
lie.
No.
Peter didn't lie.
Nos amamos todos.
We love each other.
Nos queremos todos.
We love each other.
Usted puede convivir con cualquiera de aquí sin ningún prejuicio.
We can have fellowship with anyone here.
Verdaderamente había un vacío en esa barca.
But truly there was an emptiness in that boat.
El vacío de amor.
The emptiness of love.
Porque Cristo dio su vida por amor a cada uno de nosotros.
Because Jesus gave his life for love for us.
Y cuando vio a Pedro, hermano, que el amor que Dios le había puesto en el corazón por el propósito de la muerte de Cristo se estaba yendo a su lado.
And when he saw Peter that the purpose that he had done for him of dying on the cross had gone to the side.
Cristo dijo, tengo que venir rápidamente a poner nuevamente amor en el corazón de Pedro.
I have to continue to put love again to Peter's heart.
Yo pienso, hermano, que la vida de Pedro estaba vacía de justicia.
I think, my brother, that Peter's life was empty of justice.
¿Por qué? Porque decía, Jesús ya no está con nosotros, no es justo.
Because he said, Jesus is not with us anymore, it's not fair.
Se sentía desamparado.
He felt alone.
Una persona, hermano, cuando va ante la ley.
A person, when he goes to the police, to the court.
Y no hay nadie que te represente.
And there's nobody to represent you.
Hay una necesidad.
There's a need. There's a need of justice.
¿Cuál es el vacío de nuestra vida?
What is the emptiness of our life?
Jesús traía la verdadera, hermano, respuesta para la necesidad de Pedro.
Jesus had the right answer for Peter's need.
Traía, hermano, la verdad.
He had the truth.
Traía el amor.
He had love.
Traía la justicia.
He had the justice.
Traía la solvencia necesaria para la vida.
He had that supplies that Peter needed in his life.
Y muchos dirán, hermano, estoy cansado de la vida.
And many will say, brother, I'm tired of life.
Estoy cansado de quererte realizar.
I'm tired of trying to realize myself.
Pero Dios tenía algo especial para ellos.
But Jesus had something special for them.
Juan 21:12.
John 21:12.
Les dijo. Venid, comed. Ninguno de los discípulos se atrevió a preguntarle por quién era, sabiendo que era el Señor.
Jesus saying unto them, come and dine. And none of the disciples there asked him, who are you? Knowing that it was the Lord.
Yes. Yeah. Esta es, hermano, esta es la respuesta de Jesús para nuestra necesidad.
My brother, this is the answer for our need.
Siempre la respuesta va a estar en la palabra de Dios.
Always the answer is going to be in the word of God.
¿Qué quiere decir eso, hermano?
What does it mean, brothers?
Que Jesús, hermano, tenía su barca llena.
That Jesus had his boat full.
Y lo que me sorprende a mí, hermano.
And what surprises me?
Es que Jesús nunca estaba pescando con ellos.
Is that Jesus was never fishing with them.
Hermano, ni tenía un traje de buzo.
Or not even he had his clothes to go
swimming under the water. Ni tenía un submarino.
He didn't have a submarine.
Y allá por abajo ya buscando un pez para agarrarlo para darle a los discípulos.
He wasn't under the water looking for fish to give to the disciples.
¿De dónde salió el pez?
Where did that fish came
from? ¿No se ha preguntado de dónde salió el pez?
Have you asked yourself where did the fish came
from? Cuando le dijo a los discípulos venir y comer.
When he told the disciples come and eat.
Dice que ya tenía un pez.
He said that he had already a fish.
dorándose, hay tanto que me encanta el pescado.
Sí, ¿no?
Yo nací enfrente del mar.
And in front of the sea.
Y yo me iba a la orilla del mar a agarrar a marisco.
¿Sí? I used to go out to the sea to get seafood.
Hermano, y a crudo me lo comí.
And I used to eat it. Wow.
Hermano, pero ahí estaban asaditos.
There were real fish.
Y mi papá agarraba leña que había aquí en el mar, hermano, y hacíamos un fuego.
My dad used to get wood and he used to make a fire.
Y se llevaba una olla, hermano, y ahí echamos todo el marisco. Ahí no lo comíamos.
He used to put a pot and put all the
food. Ya a la casa llegamos con la panza llena. Como
we ate it right there when we got home. We were ready full.
Hermano, qué delicioso, hermano.
It was delicious, brother.
Que salieron los discípulos y el Señor ya estaba pasando
un pesadillo. That when the disciples came, Jesus was already making a
fish. Él no estaba diciendo, ¿puedo o no puedo?
He wasn't saying, can I or I can't.
Él es decir que todo lo puede.
Oh, yes, 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 yes.
Ese fue un gran ejemplo para Pedro, hermano.
That was a great example for Peter.
Wow, ¿de dónde salió el pez?
Sí. Wow, where did that fish came from?
Si en el mar de Galilea ya no hay peces.
But in Galilee, there's no more fish.
Porque yo los he buscado toda la noche y no había ninguno.
Because I was looking for them all night and I couldn't find none.
Pero ahí estaba el que todo lo puede.
Yeah, the one that can do it all was right there.
Yeah. En Cristo Jesús hay éxito.
In Jesus Christ, there is success.
Yes. En Cristo Jesús hay éxito, hermano.
There is success in Jesus Christ.
Cuando nosotros confiamos en Él.
When we trust in Him.
Cuando nosotros dejamos todo nuestro vacío a un lado.
When we leave all the emptiness to the side.
Hermano, y buscamos la llenura del Señor en nuestra vida.
And we seek the fullness of God in our life.
Qué maravilloso es, hermano, ponerte las manos del Señor.
It's wonderful, brother, when you put your life in Jesus' hands.
Yes.
Hermano, yo tengo que caminar por fe.
I have had to walk by faith, my brothers.
Mi papá fue un hombre de fe.
My father was a man of faith.
Éramos cinco hombres y una mujer.
We were five men and a woman.
Y nos dio de comer a todos.
And he fed us all.
Y yo a veces digo, ay, Señor.
And I say sometimes, oh my Lord.
No tengo ni hijos, estoy no preocupado.
I don't even have kids and I'm all worried.
Por todo el costo de la vida.
For the life of the cost of life.
Pero mi padre confiaba en Dios.
But my father trusted the Lord.
Amen.
He trusted the Lord.
Él sabía que todo lo podía suplir.
He knew that the Lord can supply everything.
Yes. Yes.
Come.
Esa es la palabra que nosotros debemos de tomar esta esta mañana.
That's the word we have to take this morning.
No importa cuán vacío era en tu corazón.
It doesn't matter how emptiness your heart is.
¿Cuál es el problema económico o financiero?
What is your economic financial problem?
Problemas familiares, problemas en la iglesia, cualquiera.
If you have problems with your family, it doesn't matter.
Hermano, Jesús tiene la respuesta para nosotros.
Jesus has the answer for us.
Él puede llenar nuestra barca.
He can fill our boat.
No sabía que hacer un cambio.
We just have to make a change.
Yeah.
Tira la red.
Pass your net.
A la derecha.
To the right.
Tira la red. A la derecha.
Pass your net to the right.
Para mí tirar la red a la derecha significa mucho.
To me, pass your net to the right means a lot.
Dejar tus miedos.
It's to leave your fears.
Dejar tus preocupaciones.
To leave your worries.
Hermano, pensar que la bendición viene de Dios.
To think that the blessing comes from God.
Que las necesidades de mi vida, el Señor las va a suplir.
The needs for my life, the Lord can supply them.
Amen.
Y Dios lo hace.
And God makes that.
Yo llevo más de 2 años que no estoy trabajando para ninguna compañía.
It has been 2 years that I don't work for a company.
Y mi estómago está lleno.
And my stomach is full.
Tengo todo en mi casa.
I have everything in my house.
Y los encamos yo y mi esposa ahora.
And my wife and I get on our knees.
Y damos gracias a Dios.
And we give thanks to the Lord.
Amen.
Porque Él es el que bendice.
Because He's the one that blesses.
Yes, yes, yes.
Y usa cada uno de ustedes muchas veces para bendecir mi vida.
And He used many of you to bless us many times.
Claro que no me voy a quedar en manos cruzadas.
Of course, I'm not going to stay with my hands crossed.
A que se convierta todo en oro.
To everything is American gold.
No, no, yo saco.
No, I go out and look for a job.
Pero el Señor dice, venir y comer.
But the Lord says, come and eat.
Yes. Yes.
¿Qué es la comida que tenemos que comer?
What food we have to eat?
¿Cuál es la comida que necesita nuestra alma?
What is the food that our soul needs?
A lo mejor tú la tienes, a lo mejor no la tienes.
Maybe you have it, maybe you're not.
Porque en Hechos 1:4,
because in Acts 1:4,
dio también una orden el Señor.
Jesus gives an order.
Dice, y estando juntos, les mandó que no se fuesen de Jerusalén, sino que esperasen la promesa del Padre, la cual les dijo, oísteis de mí. Porque, versículo 1, 4 y 5, porque Juan ciertamente bautizó con agua, mas vosotros seréis bautizados con el Espíritu Santo dentro de no muchos días.
And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said he, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit, not many days from now.
Ahí está la nueva orden del Señor.
The new order from the Lord is here.
Ahí está lo que le dijo a Pedro.
What he told Peter.
Ahora, tira tu red a la derecha.
Now, throw your nest to the right.
Ahora, hermano, esa orden.
Now, brother, this order.
Está aquí otra vez en Hechos 1:4.
It's here again in Acts 1:4.
Llénate del poder de Dios.
Get full of the power of the Lord.
Hermano, y encontramos hoy en día, hermano, no encuentro solución a mis problemas.
Now we find in days people saying, I cannot find answers for my problems.
Como Pedro.
Just like Peter did.
Andas navegando en el mar de este mundo.
You're navigating in the sea of this world.
Hermano, y no encuentro la respuesta.
And I cannot find the answer.
Pero la palabra dice que si te llenas del Espíritu Santo.
But the word of God says, if you fill yourself with the Holy Spirit.
Que vas a tener que compartir con otros.
That you're gonna have to share with others.
Como Pedro no tuvo que compartir los peces.
Like Peter had to share the fish.
Porque el Señor le había dado tanta bendición a su vida.
Yes. Because the Lord has given him so many blessings for his life.
Dice que se hundía el bote donde estaba.
It said that the boat was drinking.
Cuando ellos obedecieron a la palabra de Dios.
When they obeyed the word of God.
El segundo orden del Señor.
The second order from the Lord.
La bendición de Dios empezó a fluir en la vida de ellos.
The blessings from the Lord start to fill their lives.
Hermano, cuando nosotros obedecemos y el Señor nos dice, llénate de mi presencia.
Brother, when we obey God and He says, fill yourself with my
cuando
presence.
Cuando estás cansado que el mundo te zarandee, te aviente, los demonios te tengan de allá para acá.
When you're so tired from the word that the demons will throw you to the sides.
Es tiempo que te vengas en la presencia del Señor. Es tiempo que dejes ese mar de
preocupaciones.
Y deja que el Espíritu Santo trate con tu vida. Porque quizá ahorita tú dices, no tengo nada que ofrecer.
Because maybe right now you say, I don't have nothing to offer you.
Quizá me puedes decir, no, amigo, préstame dinero.
Maybe they say, let me borrow some money.
Porque no hay, no tengo.
Because I don't have any.
Pedro ya estaba allá no repartiendo.
Peter was already giving to others.
Porque era tanta la bendición.
Because the blessing was so big.
Cuando nos llenamos del Señor, hermano.
When we fill ourselves with the Lord, brothers.
Nosotros podemos compartir amor.
Yes. We can share love.
Podemos compartir el gozo del Señor.
We can share the joy of the Lord.
Con todos, hermano.
With everybody.
¿Sabe por qué?
You know why?
Porque su alma está llena.
Because the boat is full.
Está llena de tal manera que ya no cabe en su corazón. Y ese gozo de Dios.
The boat is full in such a way that it doesn't feel anymore.
Amén. Gloria a Dios.
Quiere decir que el Señor quiere alcanzar a otro. It means that the Lord wants to reach.
haciendo de nosotros.
With the blessing.
No nos podemos hermano querer quedar con la bendición nomás para mí.
We don't have to stay just with the blessings for ourselves.
Una nueva orden.
A new order from God.
¿Cuántos han buscado esa nueva orden?
How many have seen this new order?
Hermano, no es simplemente venir a la iglesia para encontrar esa nueva orden.
Brothers, not just to come to church to find this new order.
Cuando llegas a tu casa, hermano, y entras a tu recámara.
When you go to your house and you go inside your room.
Y te pones allí a adorar a Dios.
And you start to praise the Lord.
Y te pones a buscar la presencia de Dios.
And you start to sing the Lord's presence.
Eso es maravilloso.
Brother, that is wonderful.
Hermano, eso yo lo hago.
I do that.
Para dar ese sermón.
To give this message.
Yo ya tuve que pasar dos, tres horas en la presencia del Señor.
I already spent 3 hours in the Lord's presence.
Y primero le predico a mi esposa.
And first he preached to me.
Todo el sermón.
All the message.
Y si ella recibe bendición, usted también recibe.
And if I bring a message to you.
Y le digo, no acabo hasta que reciba bendición.
And he said, I'm preaching to you, receive blessing.
Pero hermano, cuando terminamos de predicar en este hogar.
But when you finish doing this at home,
sentimos la presencia
de
Dios.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
This is going to be a blessing.
Nuestro corazón.
See, I want to seek to full our heart.
En la presencia del Señor primero que nada.
In God's presence first of all.
Porque si no llenamos el alma de nuestro corazón.
Because if we don't fill our hearts.
Vamos a hablar en la carne.
We're gonna talk with the flesh.
Vamos a hablar
con los sentimientos.
Vamos a hablar con el dolor que estás sintiendo.
We're gonna talk with the pain that you have inside.
Vas a hablar de los problemas que estás viviendo.
You're gonna talk about the problems you have inside.
Pero cuando el Espíritu Santo llega a tu vida.
But when the Holy Spirit comes to your life.
Nosotros empezamos a hablar de la bendición.
We start speaking about God's blessing.
Y nos olvidamos de nuestros problemas.
And we forget about all the problems.
Nos olvidamos de nuestra necesidad.
We forget about our needs.
Porque Dios ya se está haciendo cargo.
Because God is already taking control of that.
Me encanta, hermanos, la Cruz Dominical, Zacarías, hermano, pedía por todo el pueblo.
I love our Sunday school, Zacarías, was asking for all the people.
Él oraba por todo el pueblo.
He was praying for everybody. Yes.
Pero Dios se acordó de orar por
su necesidad. Thank you, Lord. God reminded to pray for his need.
Tú conoces tu necesidad.
God knows your need, brother.
Pero yo quiero que tú vengas a él.
But God wants you to come to him.
¿Cómo?
Yes. Yes.
Y ir con
and eat
del Señor.
Of God's food.
¿Y cómo podemos comer del Señor?
How can we eat from God's food?
Si nunca abres esta Biblia.
If you don't open the Bible. Yes.
O muchas veces la abres pero no la obedeces.
Or many times you open it but you do not obey.
¿Cómo podemos comer?
How can we eat, brothers?
Si la leemos pero no la compartimos.
If we read it but we do not share it with someone.
Podemos leer ahí, Dios te ama.
We can read right there, Jesus loves you, Jesus loves you.
Es para mí.
But that is not only for me.
No es para los malos.
It's not for the bad ones.
No más para mí que es bueno.
It's only for me that it's good.
Tenemos que compartir el amor de Dios.
We have to share God's love.
Y la bendición de Dios, hermano, se va a llegar en tu vida.
Gloria a Dios. And God's blessing will come to your life.
¿Por qué no nos ponemos de pie?
Let's all stand up.
Y hoy vamos a tener la Santa Cena.
And today that we're having communion.
Pidámosle perdón al Señor.
Let's ask God to forgive us.
Pidámosle al Señor reconciliación con Él.
Let's ask God to reconciliate with Him.
Pidámosle al Señor la paz que necesitamos.
Let's ask God for the peace that we need.
Pidámosle al Señor, hermanos, que llene nuestro vacío de nuestro corazón.
Let's ask the Lord to fill our emptiness of our heart.
Padre, tenemos esta mañana gloriosa.
Father, in heaven, this glorious morning.
Sabemos que no es la excepción.
We know that this is not an exceptional day.
Tú vas a preguntar la misma pregunta a cada uno de nosotros.
You're going to ask the same question to each of us.
¿Tener algo de comer para mí?
Do you have something to eat for me?
Señor, si nuestra respuesta fuera no.
Lord, if our answer will be no.
Te pedimos, Señor, esta mañana.
We ask the Lord this morning.
Que toda nuestra necesidad.
To take our needs.
Todo nuestro pecado.
All our sins.
Todos nuestros problemas.
All our worries.
Toda nuestra deuda.
Our debt.
Señor, te las entregamos a ti esta mañana.
We give it to you this morning.
Toda nuestra enfermedad.
Our sickness.
Todo lo que nos puede rodear, todo daño del enemigo. Lo entregamos en tus manos, Señor.
Hands,
y empezamos a declarar.
And we start to declare.
Señor, gracias.
Lord, thank you.
Por tu perdón.
For your forgiveness.
Gracias, Señor, por salvarme.
Thank you, Thank you, Lord, for saving me.
Gracias por transformar mi vida.
Thank you for transforming my life.
En un hombre de Dios.
In a man of God.
En un hombre que sirve a Dios.
In a man that follows God.
Gracias, Señor, por esas bendiciones que van a empezar a llenar mi hogar, mi vida.
Thank you, Lord, for those blessings that are going to start to fill my life.
Porque van a venir de parte de Dios.
And they're going to come from you, Lord.
Gracias, Señor.
Thank you, Lord.
Dios.
La cena pascual era una cena real. La cena agape era una cena real. Y el apóstol Pablo le escribe a la iglesia de Corinto cuando enseñamos. En las clases decimos, cuando vas a leer la escritura, hazle preguntas. ¿Por qué? ¿Quién? ¿Cómo? ¿Cuándo? ¿Por qué escribió Pablo esta escritura? Y todos sabemos que era a causa del desorden en lo que se había convertido la cena agape. Y el apóstol, cuando les escribe, les dice ahí en primera a los Corintios 11, 17, les dice así: Paul writes this letter to the Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 17, it says, now, in giving these instructions, I do not urge you. Paul is exhorting the Corinthian church. And he says, since you come together not for the better, but for the worse. The NIV says, your meeting do more harm than good. Amen. When you come together for the Lord's Supper, your meetings do more harm than good. And he goes on to explain, because some of you, even in a hurry, before anybody else, and don't share with others, and some of you are even getting drunk. So I'm telling you, they didn't need a cup of juice and a wafer. These people were having wine and meat and a homeo. That was the communion supper back then. Like I said, it got institutionalized and we ended up with this. And Paul keeps saying, because I hear there's division in the house and in part. I believe it. So he goes on to explain that when we come together, we come together as one body.
Yes.
Yeah. We learned in Sunday school a few Sundays ago about unity, the model, the Jesus model for the church. You guys remember that?
Yes, yes.
And what did it say? We have to be united.
Yes.
We have to be one.
Yes.
We have to come as one.
Yes.
So that is what we're doing today. We're coming to the supper table as one. Forget your differences.
Yeah.
If the Corinthians had differences, I know we have differences.
Yeah.
If the early church had problems with division, the modern church has problems with division also.
Yeah.
But what do we have to do? Overcome.
Yeah. Right.
Overcome those things. Yes. Overcome those things and come to Jesus as one. And we are going to partake of the communion. And I'm going to help. Oh, here it is.
Okay.
There, I got it. And the word of the Lord says, porque yo recibí del Señor lo que también os he enseñado, que el Señor Jesús la noche que fue entregado tomó pan. It says, on the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body." In a lot of congregations, they break the bread. You can if you want to, because his body was broken for our sins. And so some people break it when they eat it. And he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." We are remembering the death. We are remembering the sacrifice. We are remembering the day when he died for our sins. We can partake of the bread. In the same way, also he took the cup after supper and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance of me." You partake of the cup. "For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lamb's death until he comes."
Amen.
Can we come to the altar as one? Can we come forward and just giving thanks for what he has done for us?
Hi, Lord.
Brother Jerry was saying there was a time in life when we were empty.
Yep.
Worthless. There was a time when there was a void in our life. There was a time when we had nothing to offer Jesus. That time has passed, and now we have something to offer. We are worth something today. So can we come forward as one and just stand in remembrance of his death. Let us tell him, thank you, Jesus. Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus, thanking you, Lord, for the love, for the patience you had with us. Thank you for sending Jesus, your Son, to come and die for our sins. And we have been forgiven. We're saved by grace through faith in the sacrifice of Jesus. We thank you. We just praise you this morning. Lord, we give you our heart. We give you our praise. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 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 Fill our hearts with love. Fill our hearts with the Holy Spirit. Fill our hearts with compassion for others. Then we might tell them about the benefits we have as your children. Fill our hearts with gratitude towards you. Help us be good stewards. Help us, Lord, be good stewards.
Thank you.
escuchamos la palabra de Dios. Aleluya. Vamos de ensalzar su nombre. Su presencia llega a nuestro corazón. I want to read to you a blessing. El Señor te bendiga y te guarde. El Señor te mire con agrado y te extiende su amor. El Señor te muestre su favor y te concede la paz. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you. My Lord, as we leave, Father, today, I pray that you would bless our going out and our coming in. My God, today, whatever we put our hands to, Father, I pray that you would cause it to prosper. Bless your children, my Jesus, is my prayer. Holy Spirit of God, bring godly conviction to us, my Lord. We need you. We're hungry, we're thirsty, my Lord. And we need you, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' precious and holy name, I pray today. And everyone said,
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining us on Wednesday night for our Bible study. We tonight Bible study at 7 o'clock and Sunday morning at 9:30. Sunday school and then our service, praise and worship, at 11. Oh, and ladies, don't forget tomorrow a women's ministry Christmas party.